recording me for?
What?
Why are you recording me?
Why not?
I don't know.
You look gorgeous.
Let's talk about Donald Trump.
Why?
I don't know. Let's talk about...
I've seen a thing.
The Brady Bunch.
Meh. Nah.
This chick that tattooed Donald Trump's name on her side saying,
baby.
Like,
fuck you,
like
really?
Yeah, and then the caption was, smooth, now you have his name on you, you dumb bitch.
Right, right. It's so true, though.
Friendly, telling me how much you miss me. That's funny, I guess you've heard my songs. I'm too busy for your business.
Thank
Go
you.
Find a girl who wants to listen. Cause if you think I was born yesterday, you have got me wrong. So I cut you off. I don't need
right.
your love.
Thank you.
Cause I already cried enough. I've been done. I've been
You're
moving on since we said goodbye. I cut you off. I don't need your love. So you can try on.
Okay, babe, we're in our town. Is there anything we forgot at home before we go 3 hours? Got your charger, clothes, everything. You good? Babe.
Yeah. What you thinking? You think that you could be better off with somebody?
Talk down to me, that's not not gonna work now. Packed all my clothes and I moved out. I don't even wanna go to your house. Every time I sit on that couch, I feel like you lecture me. Eventually, I bet that we could've made this work and probably would've figured things out. But I guess I'm a letdown, but it's cool, I checked out. Oh, you wanna be friends now? Okay, let's put my fake face on and pretend now. Sit around and talk about the good times. It didn't even happen. I mean, why are you laughing? Must've missed that joke, let me see if I can find a reaction. No, but at least you're happy. It's like we're on the air.
Cousin's wedding. Excuse the video, the beginning of this video. I showed you my cousin's place. He's remodeling it, so this is where I'm staying, 3 hours away from home. Okay, I gotta get ready. Take you somewhere, Lance. So I'm gonna come out in the car and then have to try and find out where Lance went?
No. You don't give a fuck about me now.
So what are you gonna do? You're gonna walk home?
Why not? The fuck's the difference? You don't care? You didn't fucking care that I walked to the gas station this morning.
While I was trying to sleep.
Mm-hmm.
You texted me. It's not gonna wake me up, Lance.
Cool. But you didn't sleep at all.
No. Actually, I slept for like a few hours, yeah.
But you didn't sleep at all, right?
Might as well not have, because I fucking woke up every fucking 20 minutes.
Because it took you hours to fucking reply to me. But you woke up every 20 minutes. Right?
I'm going inside.
Yeah, good. See you never.
See me never?
Don't worry, the shit will be out of your house by the time you get home.
Thank you for a wonderful day.
Thank you for nothing.
Can I have my car keys, please? No, give me my car keys. Give me my fucking car keys, Lance. I need to go to this wedding.
Go!
Give me my car keys. I'm not going to let you take my car and leave me stranded in fucking East Jordan.
Cool.
Give me my car keys, Lance.
You left me stranded in East fucking Jordan.
Please give me my car keys.
No!
So you can take my car?
The fuck's the difference?
Is that what you're going to do?
You don't care.
You're going to take my car and leave me here. Is that really what you're going to do?
You don't fucking care.
Lance, is that really what you're going
to
do?
What the fuck do you expect me to do, Cola? Because you fucking stranded me 3 hours from
home.
You're
what? Taking my car?
No, I'm taking the car that we pay for.
No, we don't pay for. You don't pay for my car insurance. You're just going to take my car.
Why wouldn't I, Cola?
Because it's my fucking car. Is your name on it? No.
Did you put the gas in it? No.
You put $10 in, Lance.
I put $30 fucking dollars in it. Plus another $10. So call the fucking cops.
And for unity among all Christians, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Look at Jesus and gracious Lord, with all these prayer petitions to the Father, to lift up both Tyler and Renee, we thank you as these two have come forward publicly to express their love, their commitment, to hear each other, not only physically, but to hear each other's hearts as well, and that love for each other. Give them strength to live out this sacrament in a world that is full of noise. We ask this in Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
And with one heart, one mind, one voice, let us now pray as Jesus Christ has taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, thy will be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not in temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
At this time, we have what's called the nuptial blessing over the couple. It's a lot of blessing, and I would invite you to extend a hand or two over them. It would be very appropriate. Again, in this day and age, we need all the blessings that we can possibly get. And so, especially these young millennials. And so we pray. Oh God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginning of the universe, formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they may no longer be two, but one flesh. And you taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery, that in the wedding covenant, you foreshadow the sacrament of Christ and his church. O God, by whom woman is joined to man, and the companionship they had in the beginning is endowed with one blessing, not forfeited by original sin, nor washed away by blood. Look now with favor on these your servants, both Tyler and Renee, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit, pour your love into their hearts. They may be made faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace of love and peace abide in your daughter, Renee, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the sacred scriptures. May your husband, Tyler, entrust his heart to Renee, so that he bow to her as his equal, and his joint heir to the life of grace, he may always show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his church. And now, Lord, we implore you, may these your servants hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments, made one in flesh. May they be blameless in all they do, and with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before all. May they be blessed with children as they already have in Paisley, and prove themselves virtuous parents who live to see their children's children, and grant that, reaching at last together the fullness of years for which they hope, they may come to the life of the blessed, that the King of Heaven, through Christ our Lord and Savior, he says,
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace in unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
You might take this moment to show each other some sign of Christ's peace. Hugs, kisses, pumps, handshakes are all for you.
She looks beautiful.
Peace be